yo, thanks for tuning in to Celeb Source, your source for celeb news. Now, today we got Megan Thee Stallion giving us the details about her night with Tory. We got Meek Mill on Family and Fame, August Alsina's Brain Games, virtual concerts that's about to go down next week. I believe it's next week. 6ix9ine has returned, and details on the Jam Master J situation. Yes. Thanks for tuning in to Celeb Source. If this is your first time to the channel, be sure to subscribe. Make sure you hit that notification bell on the side. Make sure you hit the like button in advance. Let us know that you support what we're trying to do, putting the culture out there, making sure everybody gets this news. Now, first on deck is Megan Thee Stallion, who has had a pretty noteworthy year with the recent success that she suddenly had working with Cardi B and the video WAP and the situation surrounding artist Tory Lanez. Now, that particular incident had a lot of fog surrounding it, but we knew that the cloud would dissipate and we would get more intel on what happened that crazy night. Well, Megan Thee Stallion recently released a pic of what her foot looks like, because apparently many people on social media think she's pulling a Pinocchio and fabricating the whole event. Now, why would they think she would make this kind of thing up is beyond me. I believe the story just on the strength of the fact that it was such a strange affair and nothing that I could have imagined to have happened on purpose, which is a classic earmark of real life. You know, the classic "I started off poor selling dope and became rich" story is cliche, and I don't always believe that one. It's too basic. Anyhow, Megan took to social media to provide details on the strangeness of that night, stating, quote, "I got hit at the back of my feet because when I got shot, I was walking away facing the back." Close quote. Walking away or facing the back? Walking backwards or walking forwards looking back? Is it me? Megan added on to her post the following. She said, "Why would I lie about getting shot? Because the Migos and Cardi B said they'll do anything for clout, Megan. Come on. You just made a song with her. Do you know how many artists heard what happened to 50 Cent with the 9 shots and were like, yo, I'm gonna make up a story, right? And instead of getting hit nine times or what is it, 5 times like Pac, I'm putting down that I got hit 16 times and I'm gonna add a couple of teardrops just to let them know that I got my ops." And here we are, okay? Now, she continued on. She said, "Why are y'all so upset that I don't wanna be in the bed sad? I got my stitches out of my foot 2 weeks ago and I was ready to go celebrate WAP going number one," close quote. Yo, every time I hear the title of that song, right, I substitute in my brain the actual words for the song. So I hear like, "I was ready to go celebrate wet." You follow what I'm saying? Whatever. And she continues on. She says, "Well, I was ready to go and celebrate WAP going number one," close quote. And celebrate she did with a new Birkin bag, courtesy of Cardi B. I believe it was a Birkin. Now, after that, she dropped the photos of her wounds, and word got out that there would be possible additional charges hours later against Tory Lanez, which couldn't possibly be in his best interest. Yeah, sucks to be him. Now, years ago, the notorious B.I.G. dropped a classic song called "Mo' Money, Mo' Problems." Now, the concept of the song is exactly what you would imagine. The more income or money that you generate, the more complex your relationships become. In fact, they can become so increasingly complicated that having more money is more often a curse, in my opinion, than a blessing. You like, "Well, please, let me get that curse." Be careful what you ask for, man, okay? Meek Mill is one who has experienced this eye-opening reality firsthand when he stated, quote, "Having an argument with family and saw that they were secretly recording me," close quote. Now, he also added on, "Who are you letting hear it? Fame kind of ruined and changed a little, I must admit," close quote. Now, here is a troubling reality. You may think that having a little extra cheese will inspire your haters to look for your downfall, but you got to remember, haters are in someone's family. Why can't it be yours? Whenever we come in contact with things that are more than us, right, we tend to not like it. It highlights the fact that we may not have been lucky enough or clever enough or talented enough to make as much money as that guy. It's a direct attack on our ego. The bigger the ego, the stronger the hate, right? The harder the attack. Now, Meek's question of who are you going to let hear that also puts a spotlight on another detail involving fame and money. And that is paranoia. Yo, it's possible, right, that they could have been recording merely to say, yo, look how ridiculous your argument sounds. And all the while, he's thinking they're gonna somehow use it against him to attack his fame or his wealth. It may have nothing to do with that, but it also might. You'll disagree if you want, right? Wealth could be a blessing, but most often it's a curse. And if you can't see that, then it sounds like you're standing in line for the okie doke. And yo, a few weeks ago, we did a story on August Alsina and his entanglement affair with Jada Pinkett. The situation was rather messy, and it caused Jada Pinkett to utilize her platform, The Red Table, to discuss the actual affair, which she called an entanglement, along with her husband, Will Smith, who called it a relationship. Now, when all that was said and done, right, he then turned around, got on a mic with Rick Ross, and dropped a track called Entanglement, wallowing in the sloppiness of the situation. Now, apparently, he's been getting a lot of kickback since the public has viewed him to be more of a homewrecker in the situation. Now, he has decided to address us all by stating the following. He says, quote, I'm really a private person.
Really?
People have never known much about my love life because it's not important. I never really cared about what people thought about me, but my personal life started to seep into my business life. There were certain falsities about me, and it affected my business relationships. Close quote. Now, at this point, he tries to take control, right? He says, I'm always going to be in the driver's seat of my life and control my narrative. I can't let anybody else do that for me. It's just a part of life, and it's a part of the journey. There's a lot of love there. Sometimes truth is complicated and difficult, but my relationship with them isn't broken at all. Close quote. Broken relationship? Probably not. Moral compass? Spinning like it's over the Bermuda Triangle. Now, with the arrival of the pandemic, artists have had to get creative in order to maintain their level of income or wealth. Now, largely because they could not have the shows that may have generated large amounts of funds for them. Now, Lil Uzi Vert has decided to take matters into his own hands and provide a socially distant concert of sorts, virtually, for $15. Stating the following, it says, Lil Uzi Vert performs live for the first time since his latest release of Eternal A Take. Yo, that word says a take, okay? Staging a virtual concert for fans worldwide with no audience in attendance. The only way to watch it would be to access the live broadcast. Close quote. Now, this will all be taking place on August 27th at 6 p.m. EST, that's Eastern Standard Time, and tickets are on sale for $15. Yo, personally, you know, I love the fact that how this dude interacts with his fans, so I support the brother just on the strength of that. Now, honestly, I think this is a great way to take advantage of the current situation, especially while debuting a new album or new music. Now, hopefully, it'll bring the desired results and other artists can start to follow suit so they can get paid properly for their content. Now, New York. Tekashi 6ix9ine is back. He's back in your midst and coming out of what looked like a shoe store. Yo, lots of people were standing there just trying to get a glimpse of the artist. Yeah, the man is a celebrity, man. I guess you can't front, right? Now, one person went a bit above and beyond and apparently lost her balance in front of the artist, in which he stated on social media, he referenced the situation and stated that she tried to fall down in front of him to try to get a check. Yo, take a look. Pathetic. And finally, Now, we reported to you yesterday that those responsible for the murder of Jam Master Jay were brought to justice. Now, it has also been revealed that the dude responsible for the murder also decided to take a picture of himself in front of a mural of Jam Master Jay, expressing fake grief and adding the caption, quote, "Every now and then, I pull up on the big homie. Never forget," this is written by Carl Jordan Jr. He's the suspect that's accused of having murdered the legend. He says, "Never forget where you come from. Always show the OGs respect, because one day, hopefully, God allows you the blessing of becoming one. Hashtag Jam Master Jay forever." Close quote. Now, yo, this is disgusting. The image is one of major disrespect to the hip hop legend, and the post added, right? The post on Instagram, Rap Coalition, they found this clip, this image, and they posted it. Now, when they posted it, they added, quote, "The pose you hit on the gram, celebrating your man's life after you knocked him off. Yo, there's a special place in hell for F boys like this, posing for Instagram after he popped and murdered JMJ years earlier. Hashtag Carl Jordan. Hashtag makes Tekashi look like a stand-up dude. Hashtag sucker-ish. Hashtag F-boy and clown." Now, apparently, the story that has come out is this, right? The legend Jam Master Jay and the two other suspects that were involved in a drug deal that contained approximately a kilo of cocaine. And according to Jordan, this is his words, he was cut out of the deal by Jam Master Jay, leading to his demise. Now, if that story is true, it is a cautionary tale about the pitfalls of drug dealing. Yo, I mean, I hate to even go in that direction, but that's what it would be. Am I right or am I wrong? Now, it doesn't always play out that way, but there's no law that says it can't. Yo, let us know what you think. Do you believe the suspect's story, that it was all a drug deal gone bad? Should we even have brought that piece of information up? Or because he's a hip hop legend, should we not discuss that aspect of it? Yo, let us know what you think in the comments below. Be sure to like, be sure to subscribe. Thanks for tuning in to Celeb Source, your source for celeb news.